All right, this button right here above my finger is called the share button, but in the latest update coming to the Xbox Insiders and then eventually to the rest of you in the general release, that button can be a couple of different things now because it's now customizable through the Xbox Accessories app, which I will show you in just a second. Much like you're able to swap the buttons around, you know, A can be B and B can be A or whatever, or you can do your paddles or stuff. There's a lot of customization available with the Xbox Elite Series 1, and of course I have the 2 controller here as well. But now they've added just a little bit further steps to this, or a little bit further features to this so that you can do a couple of different things with that button. So let's take a look at it. We're gonna jump over to the Xbox and see what we have coming. All right, so here we are in the Xbox dashboard. Now I'm gonna show you how to get to this accessories app the long way around, just in case you're unsure. If you press the Nexus button or the Xbox button, that's the Xbox logo in the middle of your controller, you can go over to wherever your picture is, and you'll be able to find the settings. Now, when you click on settings, it's very easy. You just go down here to devices and connections. Almost forgot for a second. Devices and connections, and you're gonna click on accessories, and that will take you to the Xbox accessories app where you're able to make these changes. So first up here, you have my, you can see my Elite Series, Elite Controller Series 2, or Elite Series Controller Series 2, whatever. Okay, anyway, so here you see my Elite Series Controller 2, Elite Series, I can't say it. I just can't say it. But we're gonna go over here to my Xbox controller, and I'm gonna show you how to configure this. Now you can see that there is just a regular default profile. So I'm gonna click on New Profile. To keep it simple, we're just gonna call it Profile 1. And then you can see here that you have, so if you've never been in here, and I don't know if I have a video about this recently on the channel, the way some of the changes have been, but you can swap the sticks, invert the axis, swap the triggers, turn on vibration, on and off. And then you have options here like the A button, where you could make the A button actually be the B button. So the A and B swap. So for those of you, and I know you know what I'm talking about, if you have a Switch, and you play using like a Pro Controller on the Switch and try to switch back to your Xbox, like it can be a little bit confusing. I actually remap them on the Switch rather than on the controller, on my Xbox controller, but you could do that here if you wanted to. But what we're talking about today is the share button. So you see here that we have for a share button press, typically this is gonna take a photo or take a screenshot. And then you have the share button hold, which will record a video. It records the last like 30 seconds or whatever you have it set to. There's settings available to change what that does exactly, but I think by default it's like 30 or 40 seconds. And then a share button double tap would open up your recent captures. So if you're playing a game and you press it in these ways, that is what's gonna happen. Now, we have the option to say a share button press, or any of the other buttons, they all have the same options. But now you can take one of those three functions of the share button and you can have it take a screenshot like default. You can make the press record something. You could start and stop a recording. You can share recent captures. You can open the guide, which is the same as pressing the, you know, the guide button, the Nexus button. You can send a message. You can open your search. You can launch an app. You can pause or play media. You can turn your TV volume up or down. We've talked about that in some previous update videos if you have your HDMIs able to talk. For those of you who, this is an aside, your TV volume and up and stuff might not work if you're sending HDMI signals, but you're going through a capture card. So if you're a streamer or something like that and these features don't work for you for the HDMI settings, that's probably why. I know that's gonna come up, so I'm just gonna address it now. But mute TV if not. Of course, you can view your achievements, view your friends, you can see your party. You can go to a quick settings options, high contrast, night mode, color filters, narrator, magnifier, if you wanna turn on some different accessibility features. And of course, you could have up to three different of these features through the three different ways that you can interact with the share button. So it's definitely a really cool addition. I think it's gonna be a welcome addition for most people, because if you're not into sharing stuff, you know, like it makes that button more useful. Maybe you don't take a lot of screenshots, but you're an achievement hunter. You can just have it pull up achievements really quickly rather than going through the menu and trying to find it, you can just have it come up. Or if you send a lot of messages, or if you're in parties or whatever the case may be, whatever you do the most or whatever, you can kind of make this work for you. Additionally, if you don't know this, if you have an Elite Series controller, you can map those features to the paddles as well. I think you've always been able to do that. So it's nice to see that on the regular controllers that come with the Xbox S, Series S, and Series X. So if this video helped you, if you guys have any questions, comments, or any of that stuff, of course, leave it down below. I always like to hear from you, and it does help me to make videos or come up with ideas or interact with everybody. I try to stay mostly active in the comments and, of course, on Twitter and wherever else you can find me. But I definitely appreciate all the support. Thanks for checking it out, and I will catch you guys all in the next video. Thanks for watching.